light is all around us. So, you know, you see you have lights in LED form, you have lights, you know, shining from the ceiling, you have lights coming from the sun. A laser is just the purest form of light. It's just something majestic about a laser that just drives me to it and makes me want to like create them and use them and just play around with them.
My name is Akil Word-Daniels, and I'm an electrical engineering graduate student working on my Ph.D.
And not to mention, these are pretty robust, actually. These samples came out very good.
In my opinion, electrical engineering is one of the broadest fields that you could possibly do. You can go to the extreme sides of computer science and, like, you know, work on the, you know, toughest algorithms, maybe for error correction and quantum computing, or you could do optical coherence tomography for health sensing, or you can go all the way to the physics side and look at single spins of electrons using magnets to, like, work with quantum information.
And do you know why it's not like a smooth function?
So that, I think, is because, so the wave functions themselves also overlap other other barriers as well, and I think that's where some of these bumps are coming from.
I specifically work with quantum cascade lasers. What my job is to make sure that I can either optimize how quantum cascade laser works, or maybe even transfer it into a new material system. Like, if you could put a quantum cascade laser into like a silicon system, something that we use in all microelectronics, then you could get cheap, affordable systems that, you know, you could use on your cell phone.
Hey, poppers! Hey, little poppers! Yes! That's my good girl.
Academics are only half the story. I mean, there's only so much time that you could put into, like, you know, your research and the science. But in order to be a well-rounded person, you know, you have to get away from the lab. You have to go out and get involved in different student groups. You have to get out, you know, exercise your body. It's important that you exercise things other than just your scientific mindset. Or I say you should get out, play soccer, get out, get part, become part of organizations, lead organizations. My favorite thing to do, actually, in my off time, so by far, is softball. I used to play baseball in college, and so every summer we have a softball league where the departments get, you know, the departments go against each other, and we bring in things like the treasury department or maybe the facilities, and we all have these massive free-for-alls in like softball, and it's just so much, you know, bonding and laughing and just having a whole bunch of fun hitting baseballs and softballs and just playing a whole bunch of sports. After Princeton, by far, I want to be an advocate, like, for science, specifically for science policies, how they're implemented, and basically influence communities that you have a non-ideal environment for science education. I don't feel like science is really promoted enough, and I feel like even as researchers, sometimes we don't go out and, like, bring people into the science community as well. Every day I wake up and I try to think about how can I improve my communities. It's something that's, you know, a deep-seated passion for me. And my research training here is just setting me up for success in that sense. In my opinion, scientific research, the fundamentals of it, I think is a gateway on solving like all of the problems in the world.